Hello, welcome to the vlog. I'm injured.
Let's get f***ing lit, boys.
We're going to a reptile expo.
All ready to go. Oh my god. Like Brad said, we're on our way to the Schaumburg Reptile Expo. Brad's wobbling along. So the cool thing about this is Snake Discovery is gonna be there.
Thank you so much.
You're very
I just got free hornworms.
So tiny.
Good, how are you? What kind of lizard? It's a monitor, isn't it?
Yeah, he's a green monitor.
Oh my gosh. Beautiful.
He's very upset right now. He's normally much brighter.
Oh. This is what we came here for. I need me some sticks. All right, let's see.
Horse.
Oh, yay! Frogs. Oh, look at all the Pac-Man frogs.
Is it the Goliath bird eater, which is one of the bigger ones?
Oh my god, look at that. That is absolutely humongous.
Dude, it's not working.
Oh, the feet! Look! You're so chunky! I've never seen one that chunky. Look at you. I need leaf litter.
Hi vlog, so we're driving home now from the expo. Very, very cool.
Hey guys, so it's after the expo and I just wanted to do a quick haul showing everything that I got. So right when I walked in, I got this free bag. It's a Zoomed bag, and inside the bag it came with a few things. The first thing was it came with natural aquatic turtle food. I don't know, I don't have a turtle, so I don't have a use for it. And it also came with a sticker, a Zoomed sticker, which is pretty cool. Those were the two items that I got with the bag. and I purchased a few things. I didn't buy any animals this time. I did buy a few decor items. So the first thing that I got was these pods, and usually I see them in like jumping spider enclosures. So I think that I'm probably gonna use them for a jumping spider enclosure, but I'm also thinking about putting one in my toad's enclosure. But another thing that I am gonna put in my toad enclosure is leaf litter. I got this leaf litter for like $10, I think. And then the whole reason why I went was for these. I got more sticks for Zoni because we are currently in the process of redoing his enclosure. There's gonna be a video that I'm gonna post once I put these sticks in his enclosure, but we completely stripped his old cage. That'll be explained in that video when I get that uploaded. But for now, I needed to buy a few more sticks for Zoni because he's still climbing the mesh. Even though I redid the cage, he's still climbing the side. So I'm gonna be trying to fill in those gaps with branches. So then instead of him climbing the mesh, then he'll climb the branches. It's only on one side where he climbs the mesh. So I'm hoping that once I put those three on that side, he'll just use those instead because it's safer to use the branches. I got these sticks. I got all three of these for $10. Let me see if I can remember the vendor. I have a bunch of cards here. Unfortunately, I don't remember which card, but I know it's between, I think it's between this one and this one. So I'm not quite sure. There's also this one. I'm not quite sure, but I know it's one of them. But they had such a good deal on those sticks. Three for $10. These sticks, every other vendor I went to, were at least $20 to $50 for one stick. I got all three for $10, which is awesome. And all I need to do is sand it down and like sanitize it really well, because yeah, there's some stuff sticking up, but this will be perfect once it's like sanded and stuff. So I think Zoni's really gonna like it. Okay, no, I wanted to interrupt and say a really funny story about these sticks too. So me and Brad, we just got done with the expo, right? And he's carrying the sticks in his bag, and right when we walk out of the doors, the exit doors, we see two security guards. And one of them says, he said, "There's all these cool animals here, and you pay for a stick." That had me dead. Anyway, continue on. So the last thing that I got, which I actually got for free, they were giving out like a bunch of insects and stuff. Like there were a bunch of crickets, mealworms, dubias. Like they were sending all of those away for free. I got hornworms for Zoni. And for some of my jumping spiders, because they like the hornworms, especially Zoni. And usually these are so expensive. They're like $15 where I live. So getting these for free was a steal. I'm actually gonna go see if Zoni wants one now. So let's go.
He definitely wants it. Good boy, Zoni. Good boy. Is that yummy?
Now I'm gonna go put these in my toad enclosure. He's in here, as you can see.
Nope.
Oh, he did not like that. He's pretending like I can't see him, even though I really can. Anyway, he likes to hang out in there. I think this will look super cool, but the problem is I do not know where to put it. I'm trying to get rid of like this moss. Maybe I'll just put this moss like in the corner here where my this pothos is not doing well. Maybe I'll put it like up top, because he never goes up top anymore. And then I like to keep a little bit down there, but I was thinking putting it in like a corner, but I don't really like how that looks. Maybe like that. I don't know.
I really don't know. I also need to clean this out. It's so gross. Okay, I'm actually gonna go do that real quick. Of course I get the water dirty, but it's okay because this guy's gonna get it dirty anyway. I kind of like how this looks now in the corner here. I feel like there needs to be a plant like right here, so maybe I'll buy another plant. Okay, so I put leaf litter in there. I don't know if I like it or not, but it's better than nothing, so hopefully Angus appreciates it. It just fills up the space more, which is nice. Hopefully he likes it. Finally got springtails for Angus, so I'm gonna put some in now. Okay, they're in there now. You're welcome, Angus. Hey guys, so I'm editing right now and I have to be quiet because it's late and my family is asleep, but anyway, so I wanted to explain my experience with snake discovery, because that's literally the thumbnail and I almost clickbaited you guys. Me and Brad looked through the whole entire expo. We finally found her booth and it was in the back corner. Right when I got there, I saw Emily and I was just so shocked to see her so quickly right when I arrived. Everybody is starting to form a line because they announced that the meet and greet is gonna start now, right when I get there. So I get in line. I'm the fourth person in line to meet her. And I was talking to a friend who went the day before on Saturday. I went on Sunday. And he said that the line for her was so long. Like, apparently some people waited hours. I was the fourth person in line to meet her. I got so lucky. I was so nervous to meet her because I get very bad anxiety when I meet people I look up to, and I don't know how to form big girl sentences. And it's kind of like an icebreaker at school. Like, they tell you, say your name and say your favorite ice cream to the class. And you're just sitting there, like, thinking what you're gonna say. That's exactly what I was doing in the line. I was, like, trying to figure out what to say to her. And of course, right when I'm starting to, like, try to come up with what to say, I'm next. And I'm like, oh my god. So I go up to her and I'm like, oh my god, can I have a hug? And she's like, yeah. And so then, like, she gives me a hug. And then I'm like, I love your videos. Like, my favorite is the one where you teach us how to make a toad enclosure, because I have a toad. She's like, oh, they're so underrated. And I said, yeah, they really are. I went to the Scott's All Animal Expo, and I was trying to find a toad. I had trouble finding the toad because there were no vendors there, but then a vendor came late and I got to get a toad, and then she interrupted me and she's like, oh, is that vendor here? And I looked around like, I don't think so. I was like, oh. And then I was like, no, I don't, I haven't seen him. And then she's like, oh. And then I said, but yeah, then I got my toad. And then, like, she didn't really respond and I didn't know what to say. And Brad is just standing there like, And then I just ask her for a picture and she's like, yeah, of course. And then I'm just like, in my mind, I'm just thinking they're saying, wow, I was so awkward. So if Emily ever sees this video, I'm sorry for being so awkward. I just think that was so funny. That was my experience meeting Snake Discovery. She's super kind, super sweet. She's literally the same in her videos and in person, which is awesome. I love people like that. So if you ever have a chance to meet her, do it. And don't be as awkward as I was.
That's gonna be it for this video. If you like my content and want to see more animal stuff, I recommend hitting the subscribe button. That helps me out. I'm currently trying to break 100 subs and we are so close, so thank you for all the support. Make sure you like this video, comment below if you enjoyed it. Make sure you check the description, and I think that's it. So thanks for watching. Bye.